Every year when a new FIFA drops, the ratings get released and we always see controversy surrounding the new changes to the players we love. I've noticed a trend this year that some Wonderkids in career mode have been disrespected, not just in terms of overall, but potential. So what I've decided to do today is gather up as many of the most downgraded Wonderkids in FIFA 21 career mode and transfer them all into one team. It might just be a level 2 low, but we have chosen Stevenage in League 2 for all these Wonderkids to unite. Every single one of them have something in common. They've all been downgraded in terms of potential and in some cases overall from FIFA 20 career mode to FIFA 21. We're going to find out today, can we revive the 29-man Wonderkids squad? Can dynamic potential and the overpowered growth this year boost their potentials and get them back performing to their best? Let's see if this young crop of Wonderkids can transform and develop into icons of world football. I'd like you to meet the downgraded Wonderkids of FIFA 21. Meet your starting 11. We've got them lining up in a 4-2-4 formation. Signs of a very young, eager, and pragmatic team. They're hungry for success and willing to climb back. In between the sticks, the goalkeepers include Walker Farinez, the Venezuelan shot stopper, and Albin Lafont, a genuine career mode legend. They've both received downgrades this year, and they can both fight for that number one spot. To cover the back line first in the starting 11, we've got Thierry Correa, the Portuguese right back. He has gone from an 84 potential in FIFA 20 to 79 in FIFA 21. His sideshow Bob Esquerstal isn't going to save him from a downgrade this year, as Liverpool's own Van den Berg, the Dutchman, has received a minus 4 decrease to his potential from 84 to 80. Malik Fiore, the Finnish centre back out of Schalke, he has received a potential downgrade from FIFA 20 to 21, only a slight decrease from 80 to 79. To cover a left back, it is Cipriano from Shakhtar Donetsk. The Brazilian has suffered a potential decrease from 83 to 80. Now the captain of this squad, the playmaker, the dynamic midfielder, is going to be one of my personal favourites in recent years that have emerged onto the scene. It is Adil Ayouchiche. The Frenchman upon his addition into FIFA 20 had an 84 potential at PSG. He made the transfer move to Saint-Étienne in the summer and he's received a 79 potential for FIFA 21. Alongside Ayouchiche in the midfield, to couple him, it is Ricky from Empoli. In a similar case to Theo, just a minor downgrade from 81 potential to 80. You know, it's a BCHD. He's got to have an Italian stallion somewhere in the mix. To link up with each other on the wings, it is De Ketelaere and Lanez Jr. Starting off with the Belgian, he had a potential in FIFA 20 of 86. Now, that's been downgraded to 82. Despite his brief appearance in FIFA 20, he's downgraded from an 84 to an 82. Finally, to complement the attack to round off this team, it is Broja and Ferreira, the formidable interchangeable strike duo up front. Yet another American in the mix, Jesus Ferreira. He's received a minus 4 downgrade, depleted from 85 potential to 81. And Chelsea's youth academy prospect, the Albanian Broja, it's another minus 4 from 84 potential to 80. Now, if you take a look on the bench, there might be some familiar faces, a few youth academy prospects, hidden gems in the game that you should all be aware of. Just because their stats and potential have been downgraded, it doesn't mean you should stray away from signing some of these absolute beauties in the side. To save you time, I'm not going to go through every individual single downgrade. We'll just be here for too long. I'm just here to guarantee you that every single one of these Wonder Kids have been downgraded in terms of potential and received a hit in that factor. Believe you me, they are out for blood. Some career mode legends, some channel favorites, some classic names, a beautiful mix of talents from across the world. They go down all right. Come on, it's a pretty decent squad for now. With a lot of future promise ahead and the road up to the Premier League awaiting, there's a lot of simulating to be done, so strap yourselves in and get ready for the ride. Despite the Wonder Kids being downgraded and EA throwing them some shade, they're on the fight back and they've absolutely crushed EFL League 2 with 108 points, finishing on top, gaining automatic promotion to the third division. Could the road to the Premier League officially be on, and can they achieve it in 3 back-to-back promotions? That's the big challenge, but the best performer and the top goal scorer by quite some margin is Arnaud Kalimuendo. 40 goals and 4 assists from the Frenchman. The PSG youth product is firing on all cylinders, and Jesus Ferreira, his strike partner, is right alongside him. It's like Batman and Robin Hood. 24 goals and 8 assists for the American, Charles De Ketelaere. I still really don't know how to say this guy's name, but the Belgian with 18 goals and 7 assists from left wing. Ahmed Kudaku really has chopped in with 6 goals off the bench, and Thierry Correa from right back, 4 goals and 9 assists, bombing forward Adil Ayouchiche, the captain, one of my favourites, 4 goals and 11 assists for the French midfielder, the baller, linking up alongside his fellow countryman Enzo Lodice. I really should brush up on these pronunciations. With the majority of them, I really have no idea, besides the Italian ones, of course. For the rest of them, hopefully hopefully they make a name for themselves and I'm forced to know their name. Our main man in between the sticks, Sacre Bleu, the French are dominating with 59 appearances. It's Albert Alphonse getting 28 clean sheets in between the sticks. It's been a year of grinding it out in the fourth tier and there's nothing but upgrades sprayed all across the pitch and in the entire squad. The revival is well and truly underway here at Stevenage. Just like that, if you thought League 2 was a piece of cake, they have breezed by League 1, blasting their way up to the second division. The championship is calling their name. Complete and sheer utter dominance. You love to see it. Unfortunately though, they were knocked out to Arsenal 3-0 in round 4 of the FA Cup. Here in the Carabao, they ventured all the way to the quarterfinals, beating out United or losing out to United 5-4 on penalties. You can just tell from the development panel that so much work is getting done off the pitch. We're being productive and effective with these Wonder Kids. Here were our MVPs, the squad report in their second campaign, and it's Kelly Muendo completely replicating his stats from last season. That is a first. Out of all the career simulations I've ever done on FIFA, that is the first time I've ever seen that. So congratulations, Arnold. You're making history. Zekitalele with 63 appearances is really coming out of his shell with 28 goals and 9 assists from left wing. Jesus Ferreira, he's just been blown out the water in comparison to his strike partner, but we've got to appreciate what the American has done for our front line. 22 goals and 6 assists. It's probably one of his best campaign turnouts to date. He's the only player to achieve the output of double figures in both goals and assists. 15 goals and 21 assists for the captain, Adil Ayushish. Lanez Jr. with 8 goals and 9 assists. Enzo Lodice with 6 goals and 12 assists. And Thierry Correa is keeping up this attacking prosperity at right back with 5 goals and 4 assists. Roberto Piccoli off the bench with 4 goals, proven to be an impact substitution. I know we're giving all the attacking involvement from the flanks to Correa, but Cipriano on the other side, 3 goals and 7 assists. Albert Alphonse has garnered up 29 clean sheets and got himself 2 assists. Now it's all sunshine and roses looking at the starting 11, all the Wonder Kids growing and the goals and assists they're producing, but on the bench, it's kind of a different story. With dynamic potential, unless you're starting week in, week out, your Wonder Kids' growth and development is going to plummet. Not the growth and prosperity we're used to seeing with these young guns and talents. Even in the substitutes, we've got some solid reinforcements. They're just not getting the game time and the growth they deserve. It's a sad reality, but we push on, we move, and in season 3, the downgraded Wonder Kids have a point to prove in the championship. If you haven't bought into the hype already, you best believe you're on the hype train right now, because Stevenage's downgraded Wonder Kids have finished out on top of 3 separate leagues, gaining back-to-back-to-back promotion. It's the journey up the English divisions that a club would dream of. In the FA Cup, unfortunately, they were knocked out to United once more, 3-0 in the round 4 replay. Over in the Carabao Cup, the Red Devils really have the agenda against Stevenage right now, as a 3-0 elimination see them bow out of the quarters. Here were the promotion protagonists of this Wonder Kids squad, and Kelly Muendo, he's on top again. The Frenchman couldn't replicate it 3 years in a row with 40 goals and 4 assists, but he's garnered 31 goals and 3 assists in the second tier. Very commendable and extreme numbers he's producing. It's his playmaker partner in crime, De Ketelaere. The next KDB, the Belgian, with 21 goals and 2 assists in the championship. But Ada matches 20 goal contributions in 52 appearances, now reaching into the 80s with a plus 2 to his overall. And Adil Ayushish, the captain, who has lifted up every single league trophy, 9 goals and 8 assists to his name from the midfield. German Valeda, who we've seen have a bit more involvement this season, 10 goal contributions off the bench. And Thierry Correa, he's making moves in defense as the Portuguese right back with 5 goals and 9 assists again. His left back partner on the other side of the pitch, Cipriano, with 5 goals and 3 assists. All of a sudden, Lanez Jr. has turned into the playmaker of his dreams with 18 assists and 4 goals. Our man Enzo with 2 goals and 11 assists, 13 goal contributions from the Frenchman. I want to highlight some players who don't really get the game time and haven't bursted through to the starting 11 in these 3 seasons. They're going to be the backup brigade as we head up to the Premier League. A safe pair of hands in between the 6, our number 1 with 2 assists and 22 clean sheets. Here is their best possible starting 11. They have the tools at their disposal, ready to fight and survive in the Premier League come season 4. The top flight is calling their name and their careers have been well and truly revived. We knew they were good, but come on, this good, they finished in their first debut season in the Premier League 6, just outside those European places. Finishing above the likes of Arsenal, Everton and Leicester, it has been a more than successful Champions League campaign, avoiding the drop, and it's Leeds United, Sheffield and West Ham to be relegated. During the FA Cup, they made it all the way to their first final, and at Wembley, they lost out 1-0 to the Gunners in the final. Unfortunate scenes, but what a run it was. Breezing past these expectations, Charles De Ketelaere is the top performer in their Premier League debut with 28 goals and 8 assists, 36 goal contributions in 50 appearances. I was expecting him to be known for his playmaking abilities and for his assists, but he's turned out to be a goal scorer midfielder and a true out and out winger. Meanwhile, Jesus Ferreira, for the first time, has finished above the likes of Calimuendo, who has only scored 17 goals. In comparison, he set lofty high expectations in the first three seasons, so it's just weird not to see him completely dominating. Lanias Jr. with 8 goals and 9 assists, Cipriano from left back with 4 goals and 3, and again Roberto Piccoli off the bench, 4 goals to his name, and he's proven to be a real super sub as Thierry Correa with 6 assists from right back. The captain, Ariel, I mean, he's kind of teetering off. His growth hasn't been as exponential as I predicted or assumed. The captain having a rough time here in the Prem so far. Hopefully that's just a season, a blip. Let's see if he can adjust in years to come. Zenzo surpassed him in overall, now at an 80 with 6 assists and a goal. A couple have to take a back seat and be the supporting cast, but you can't have the MVPs without the supporting class, and especially without this man, Albin Lafont, the career mode goat, now at an 86 overall with 15 clean sheets under his belt. They've laid down the formations, they've established their legacy, and here is how the starting 11 is looking. Midfield right now is a little bit of a problematic area, lagging behind some other departments. I'm keen to see the downgraded Wonder Kids prosper in season 5. Is the conclusion to their second Premier League season. It's resulted in a position one better from 6th to 5th, 5 points away from qualifying for the Champions League, and they collected 71 points in the process. Manchester United and City battle it out for the title as the Red Devils come out on top, but they still finish above Chelsea and Arsenal. Incredible scenes here from the downgraded Wonder Kids, who have turned things around for themselves. We've got a good bunch of lads, it's a good crop of Wonder Kids. They have captured the FA Cup at Wembley, beating out Southampton 2-0. They win their first piece of silverware. Unbelievable stuff. In the Carabao, they could have had a cheeky cup double. Liverpool, unfortunately, just getting the better of them 2-1. They actually qualified for the Europa League in 6th. Getting drawn into Group B, they actually finished on top against the likes of Sporting, Standard Liège, and Celtic. They're out of 32. They took down Russian outfit CSKA Moscow 4-2 in aggregate. And over in the round of 16, they eliminated the Gunners of Arsenal 4-2 again. They unfortunately experienced defeat to the Europa League specialist Sevilla 3-2 in aggregate. And they eventually went on to not even win the final. It was Spurs to take it out 3-1. The production levels and the productivity continues to be at an all-time high for our Belgian, our KDB, Deke Talarie, for 30 goals and 6 assists. The winger's changing the game. He's got a point to prove. 36 goal contributions as Calimuendo is back to being one of our highest scoring players with 29 goals and 6 assists. No second season syndrome here as Jesus Ferreira, he's Mr. Consistent. He's always up there in the charts. The American back at 18 goals and 10 assists, 28 goal contributions, and Adil Ayouchis is back to his fiery best. The captain leads by example, being the best contributor in terms of assists. It is Cipriano with 10 goal contributions from left back. Correa has been a standout from right back, 7 goals and 9 assists in 70 appearances. Lanias Jr. has also pulled his weight with 18 goal contributions, 12 assists. Mutuku and Valeda off the bench with 5 goals apiece. Piccoli again, he's Mr. Consistent in terms of just getting 4 goals a season and chilling out. Enzo Ayushish's midfield partner with 3 goals and 9 assists. They take a look all the way down at Albin Lafont, now at an 88 overall, 31 clean sheets in 67 appearances. It's a magnificent achievement. Take a look at the highest rated player so far, Albin Lafont. He's got the goalkeeper position on lock. It's a 3-way tie for second place, but we have players that have the potential to reach the 90s and players still just entering the 80s range. You can definitely see the golfing class between our first 11 and our backup brigade. A 6 overall leap from Fred Ines to Kutuku is quite worrying. You always knew something like this was bound to happen. It's unpreventable in many cases. In terms of the financial department, our highest valued player is Calimuendo. The transfer market value of 160.5 million and Charles exceeding the 9-figure range, 108.5 million pounds. It has been a gargantuan season. The pressure was on and the Stevenage boys have provided with 93 points. They finished off the campaign on top, Premier League champions for the first time ever. It's taken 6 years, just over half a decade. Downgraded Wonder Kids have worked together, bound together, and we trusted the process throughout the divisions. In the Community Shield at Wembley, it's been a 2-1 win for the boys over United. It feels good to get a bit of revenge over them. It looks like we have an FA Cup final on our hands against Manchester City at Wembley again, so the chance for a domestic treble. They didn't see the same fate in the Carabao Cup, eliminated in the semi-finals on aggregate 5-3 to Liverpool. Second time's a charm in the Europa League is in Group J. They were drawn up against AZ Bruges and Midtjyllands. Coming through with a tabletop and performance in the round of 32, they took down Lille 6-1. Complete and utter domination in the round of 16. They saw through Atalanta 4-2 to book their place in the quarters. Saw them progress past Monaco 3-2. In the semi-finals, it was an away day masterclass over none other than Bayern Munich 3-3 on away goals, and they booked their spot in the Europa League final, the Big Dance. Two Big Dances are calling their name, and what a grand finale to end off the season. First off, here's the starting 11 to face Manchester City at Wembley. Let's quick team this one, and the power of Burger King, may it be on their side, and it is. It is our KDB, proven to Manchester City why he is even better. A professional performance, and they held onto that 1-0 lead for their dear lives. They proved themselves domestically, capturing the domestic treble. However, continentally is a whole different beast. It's the Eagles of Lazio standing in their way, and they're going out to battle again tonight. We're quick simming this one up against the Bianco Celeste. It's another sensational 2-0 performance. The downgraded Wonderkids complete and utter domination with 62% possession. Broja off the bench to get a goal to seal it, and that was that. Sorry, lads, I was getting ahead of myself. I said it was the quadruple, four pieces of silverware in one season, but the media are claiming it as the treble. They don't count the Community Shield to be a trophy. How dare they? In their most illustrious career to date, there was still more to work on the training pitches in the development subsection. This team right now is absolutely cracked, and they haven't even gone to battle in the Champions League yet. That is still to come. Thanks to dynamic potential, we now have our first over 90 rated player. We could have picked this one from a mile away. It's Kenny Muendo, proving his goal scoring credentials with 40 goals and 5 assists in season 6. Getting that plus 4 boost to propel him to the 90 status. Jesus Ferreira, he earns himself 28 goals and 7 assists with a plus 2 now at an 88. One of two players to get double figures in both goals and assists, and his partner to do that with him is Enzo. 13 goals and 12 assists are from the Frenchman Lanius Jr. 16 assists from the right wing and 8 goals to his name. Ayushish has provided just being the anchor, the deep line playmaker we needed in the middle. Our pivot grabs 14 assists and 5 goals. We get Marcelo, we've unearthed a brand new Brazilian left back, Cipriano, 4 goals and 7 assists. Quickly off the bench with his seasonal 3 goals, and Broja. The Albanian got the goal in the Europa League final to steal it. What a man. Both Kuduku and Valeda off the bench with 2 goals each, and Correa from right back with a goal and 5 assists, now rated at 88. Here were Lafont's performances this time around, and 3 assists and 27 clean sheets. Brilliant stuff from our French shot stopper, our highest rated player. He is now tied with his fellow countryman, Kelly Muendo. It's a predominant French outlook on the squad, and they have delivered. Financially, Kelly Muendo is the closest to that £200 million transfer market value, now valued at £180.5 million. Succeeding in England being a fairy tale story, playing Champions League for the first time in season 7. Can it be lucky season 7? Let's tune in to find out. We all knew their eyes were set on the Champions League, and they've gone back to back in the Premier League, proven that they can fight on multiple fronts. Defending the championship and coming out on top by 3 points, Liverpool, United and City finish off the top 4, and getting relegated is Wolves, Fulham and Swansea for the final time. They couldn't maintain the prestigious Community Shield, and it was a 2-0 defeat to Liverpool at Wembley that saw them take it home. They're up in another FA Cup final, this time to Spurs. They're two teams that traditionally don't really win any pieces of silverware, so let's see these two sides go to battle. First time in 7 years, it's a Carabao Cup triumph against Aston Villa in the Big Dance. 2-0 win, seeing him capture yet another one to the trophy cabinet. The Europa League winners up against the Champions League winners in the UEFA Super Cup, and it's a sign of the times as Stevenage propelled to victory in a 3-1 effort over Borussia Dortmund. It's a treble of trophies. The victories have been elite. In the UCL, it's the opportunity for 4 in season 7. Atalanta, Club Brugge and Payot couldn't beat them out in Group G. Finishing on top in the round of 16, they breezed past the Belgian outfit, Genk 5-1 on aggregate, over against one of the best and prestigious teams in Champions League history, Barca, eliminated 3-1 on aggregate in the semi-finals. It was a 5-4 thriller against Juve on two legs. 2-2 was the final score, and you know what that means. It's a big dance up ahead. They've booked their spot in the Champions League final against none other than United, who have been thwarting them throughout this whole career simulation. This is more than a final. The downgraded Wonderkids are out for revenge. We have to take care of FA Cup victory first. Here is their first task at hand. It's a battle in London against the North Londoners, Are they going to prosper through this one? And no, unfortunately, the first final they've lost that with Quicksim, Rodrigo and Heung-min Son have proven the victory as Kalimuendo missed a penalty, and it looked like they dominated, if not had more shots than the opposition. Unfortunately, couldn't finish them off on the day. Jose's men got the better of our downgraded champions. Here is the starting 11 headed through to the final up against United. But before we do that, we are going to see the best performers this season. Who have been the main protagonists? Are they going to be the same old stars? And you bet they will be, with Kalimuendo finishing this time out on top. 92 overall, 39 goals and 7 assists. The Frenchman firing on all cylinders. You can't forget the Belgian Charles. KDB is shaking in his boots with 28 goals and 6 assists. He is absolutely unstoppable. Jesus Ferreira, who's consistently been in our top 3 best. Enzo prospering in midfield now at 88 overall. It's Adil Ayushish. Our most prosperous captain has achieved 20 assists and 6 goals. The main playmaker. And Lainez Jr. He's been injured for a bit this season, but he's gathered up 12 goals and 4 assists. The Eddie Correa from right back has collected 10 goal contributions. Here is your final look at the entire squad. Every single one of these players were downgraded headed into FIFA 21, but through the power of dynamic potential, we have turned things around. And Alban Lafont, 28 clean sheets and 2 assists for our French shot stopper. Let's get it done then, United. We're up for this one. They've got fire running through their veins. Desperate to bounce back after their FA Cup final defeat, and we have lift off. It's completely different looking United side with Wonderkids galore. So it's Wonderkids FC versus downgraded Wonderkids FC. Oh, United facing through, and Lafont with an epic double save. That's going to round off the first half, and to say the first 45 were uneventful is an understatement. You know what? We're jumping on in. You're kidding me. Oh, this kick clash is so annoying. Why? Find a space on the right-hand side. Can Cipriano shut him down? And no, Buadu gets it through to Lafont, and he palms it away. Oh, no, Rashford in the clear. Buadu finds empty space. Who was marking him? Defense completely gone to sleep, and I just can't see anything, to be fair. So this is going to be a struggle to fight back in the last 30 minutes. In a game of few goals, we're going to have to find a couple to get us over the line. A bit sloppy, but Kalimuendo gets there, and he's going to beat out Umtiti for pace. Kalimuendo just feels rapid, and surely the man who's been firing goals since League 2 has struck in the Champions League final, the number 29, finding his form in the big moments. He's a big game player, and the stage lights up for him. The podium was there for him to take the opportunity, and he took it by the scruff of the neck. Drakosha stunned in between the sticks, and his pace got in there. The finesse shot killed to perfection. Oh, dearie me, it's off the crossbar from United, firing warning shots in the dying embers of the match. We come out unscathed, thankfully, so we can ply it through. Here, Lainez Jr. All of a sudden, Kalimuendo in the middle. Kalimuendo, surely he's onside, and he couldn't get a foot to it. The Brazilian bombing down this left-hand side. He needs a good delivery inside, as United aren't really pressuring, and it is D. Ketelaere, our KDB throughout all these years, surely gets the winning goal with one hand on the trophy. The power of Burger King compels them. And Cipriano just left to explore free territory and so much green grass to run onto. And our Belgian with the love tap to fire it home into the top left-hand corner. Get that up, yeah, United, as the downgraded Wonderkids rejoice. Our number 90 with his 7th goal in the Champions League. And that might be the one to seal it. Ends it there. And the Stevenage downgraded Wonderkids achieve glory in the Champions League final. They hold on. And that man, Adil Ayushish, leads his men out, collecting the W. A dramatic 87th minute winner from that man right there. From the worst downgraded Wonderkids, their potential was slashed in comparison to last year's game, was nowhere near. They have come out on top with dynamic potential on their side. They're a good bunch, a mixed bag of characters, and they'll celebrate tonight with one of the best pieces of silverware you could win in the world. From the French heroes, to the Italians, to the two Americans in our four-man attack, each and every single one of them deserve praise. And that's gonna be it for today's video. I've been Sir BCHD. Hopefully you did go on to enjoy. Smash a like on the video, hit subscribe, turn on the notifications, as we're on the road to 100k before 2021. Follow all my socials linked down in the description. And as always, I will catch you guys on the very next video. I did it.